careful. The underbrush can be a bit noisy this time of year. If an animal hears you approaching, you better believe it'll turn tail and run. Or worse. Would you look at that view? Never gets old, I'm telling you. From up here, you can see a lot of great hunting spots in the area. Valmont's not only where Hope set up camp, it's also famous for the railroad bridges along the old North Pacific line. Keep an eye out for them if you can in between blacktail hunting. Or, why not use them as vantage points? I once bagged a whitetail from the Runaki Bridge. Be sure to stop by one of the outposts. You can find pretty much anything you need there. Sounds like Richard's gonna need a helping hand. Sorry, we got this full-blown survivalist fella living out here all year round. Richard Hope. He got in a bit of trouble, it seems. I can fill you in on the details later. Catching on quickly. Nice place, right? You won't find a soft bed in many parts around here. Don't forget to stock up before heading out. Looked like it had been really messed with. I don't know if it was an animal or some tourist troublemakers, but I'm up in Topeka all day and can't look into it. Listen, I know you probably have other plans, but you're in the right neck of the woods, and I'd sure be grateful if you could just stop on by and have a look. Hope showed up here 2 years ago. Said something about getting off the grid. I heard he lost his family in an accident while he was deployed overseas in the army. Hit the poor guy hard. I guess out here you only need to look out for yourself. It's easier that way. Not the most cheerful fella, to be honest, but he's earned his peace for sure. Let's find out whoever did this. gentle now. Take a deep breath to steady your aim. White-tailed deer are often slightly bigger than the blacktail, but they're quicker to flee if they sense danger. Thank you. so that's a hit. Follow the blood trail to find it. Shouldn't have gone far. You're after moose. Tough animals, I tell ya. Be sure to bring the right caliber weapon to bring them down. Oh, and while their eyesight ain't too good, their smell is. So keep your scent and the wind in mind. Feet moving, I see. Just remember to take a breather before shooting anything. Look at that. Your first reserve trophy. Go ahead and harvest it. Track of where the wind is blowing. Animals will pick up your scent easily if they're downwind from you. Thank you.
You're cool, how are you? I've only been on for 35 minutes, lad. Well, I need water, so get a wee hit up. That's the different account I'm on, so I'm maybe adding to this one too.
You'll find coyotes all over the reserve, so they're not the most difficult to hunt. They're pack animals, so they respond well to callers, but they can also get aggressive when alerted. So be careful. is usually the kickoff point for hikers coming to the reserve. And the same goes for a lot of hunting parties or seasonal sports fishermen. They often rent one of the cabins we have up by Gila Lake and set out from there. Not so much this time of year, though. Ever need a place to rest? There's a cabin in each outpost. I had them gutted and redone last season.